Are y'all ready? I'll give you a little bit of explanation as we go through, but mainly I'll let you enjoy what you're seeing. So again, our first two guests, of course, will take their shoes off because you would never wear shoes in a tatami mat room. And then scoot through the entrance as a sign of respect. Instead of walking through the entrance, they will slide through the entrance on their knees. Notice that fan she puts in front of her to kind of show respect. And since Haruko-san is our main guest, she has entered first. After the guests are seated, the hostess will come in and serve them a tray of sweets. The guests are going to wait to eat their sweets until just before they get their bowl of tea, because it tastes really good, that combination of the sweets and tea together. She just invited the guests to eat the sweets. Okashio dozo. Please eat the sweets. She said, I'd like to begin now. The container she's carrying in, she's going to use to put her wastewater in. Again, this silk cloth is called a fukusa, and she will, as she's folding it, she will use it to purify her other utensils. Active folding that she's doing right now actually serves to, that's a purification for the fukusa itself. Now she's picked up the natsume. This is the container that contains the powdered green tea. Go throughout. The main guest has a special role. She is the one that kind of communicates with the hostess, and she's just asked, tell me a little bit more about the scroll and the flowers and the tokenomics. So it's very polite to admire and ask the hostess to tell more about the items that she's picked out to display during the event. She's pouring some hot water in the tea bowl. She's not making the tea quite yet, but she's using that hot water to warm up the bowl and purify it and clean it out a little bit so it makes a delicious bowl of tea. She's about ready to begin making that first bowl of tea. So she asked the first guest to go ahead and eat her sweets because this is the right timing. This is the perfect time for her to eat her sweets. Just about the time she finishes, she'll have a bowl of tea waiting for her. Notice is every tea bowl has a front to it, and if you'll notice, the hostess turned the tea bowl so the front was facing towards the guest when the guest came to pick up the bowl. You will also notice that the guest right now is asking the second guest, may I go ahead and drink this tea before you? Very polite, thanking the hostess. And she'll turn the tea bowl so that she's drinking out of the back of the bowl. So we want to respect and honor that front side of the tea bowl. There's about 2.5-3 sips worth of tea in there. So she will definitely drink the whole thing. And to show how delicious the tea is, she'll slurp the very last sip to get every last drop. she wants to take a close look, because every tea bowl is a work of art.
Oh, he's not in our one.
Usagi, say hi, and we're gonna take his eyes. Are you ready to take his eyes?
I am. また今年のエッドで綺麗でございますね。
So, she just asked, tell me about the tea bowl. This tea bowl, particular tea bowl, was made in the area of Hagi, Japan. It's got a design of a rabbit leaping over waves, and there is a haiku poem about a rabbit in the moonlight leaping over waves. But I don't know that story. Now our hostess is going to use the bowl. She's going to clean it out and make another bowl of tea for our second guest.